Okay, this scene is from the episode called Bread and Circuses from season 2, episode 14. Now, this is one of those episodes where they find a planet that's like Earth, but. So, this place is like Earth, but it's as if Rome never fell. So, you still have gladiators, you still have all that shtick, only now it's more modern day. So, Kirk, Spock, and McCoy, I like to call them the Banff Trio. So the Banff Trio lands on this planet, and of course they get into trouble. So Spock and McCoy wind up fighting in the gladiator ring, not against each other, against two separate enemies, and Kirk has to watch. And Spock winds up saving McCoy's life while all the fight's going down. And then after the fight, Spock and McCoy are thrown in a cell for cheating, and Kirk is taken off to some kind of weird room where he's seduced by some slave chick. So, and Spock and McCoy have no idea where Kirk is gone. It's just Spock and McCoy in this cell, and they have no idea where Kirk is. Spock has just saved McCoy's life, and go.
Emotions are foreign to me, Doctor. I'm merely testing the strength of the door.
For the 15th time. I know we've had our disagreements. Maybe they're jokes. I don't know. As Jim says, we're not often sure ourselves sometimes. But what I'm trying to say is...
Doctor, I am seeking a means of escape. Will you please be brief?
Well, what I'm trying to say is you saved my life in the arena.
Yes, that's quite true.
I'm trying to thank you, you pointed-eared hobgoblin!
Yes, you humans have that emotional need to express gratitude. You're welcome, I believe, is the correct response. However, Doctor, you must remember that I'm entirely motivated by logic. The loss of our ship's surgeon, whatever I may think of his relative skill, would mean a reduction in the efficiency of the Enterprise, and therefore...
No, why? You're not afraid to die, Spock. You're more afraid of living. Day you stay alive is just one more day you might slip and let your human half peek out. That's it, isn't it? And security. Why, you wouldn't know what to do with a genuine, warm, decent feeling.
Really, Doctor?
I know. I'm worried about Jim, too.
Well, after this, I was just gonna pack my bags and go home. I mean, was that not... Would you still need me to... All right, sure, no, that's fine. So, what was telling about this scene was everything. Everything, all of it. Top to bottom, left to gay. You don't get much more explicitly queer than that. But just for fun, I'm gonna break it down for you. Spock has genuine, warm, decent feelings for Kirk. Genuine, warm, decent, feelings. Have you heard anything more dangerously ambiguous? I mean, I'm sure for the time, this was probably really subtle. I mean, look at the world well lost. We saw that coming from a mile away, and it's the same case here, because when we watch this kind of stuff now, we all know what's really going on. And this isn't even the last time they use this feelings trick in Star Trek either. They do it again in the first movie, only by then, it's simple feelings, and Spock is confessing them directly to Kirk rather than to McCoy about Kirk. And speaking of McCoy, can we talk about McCoy for a second? Because he knows. McCoy knowing is all over this series. He is probably known from day one of this entire freaking 5-year mission. Only now, in this scene, after years of being trapped on the Enterprise with Kirk and Spock being more obvious than a penis float at a pride parade, McCoy has finally had it up to here with Spock's shit, pushes him up against the wall and goes, "Look, I know why you're such a bitch all the time. It's because you're afraid of your little emotions peeking out and everyone seeing how human you really are." To which Spock can only respond with a look of complete shame, making McCoy go, "Ah, I'm right, aren't I? You wouldn't even know what to do with a warm feeling if you let it out." And now, Spock has two choices about how to handle this. He can either win the argument or lose the argument. Unfortunately for him, winning the argument means confessing he has feelings for Kirk. Losing the argument would be the much wiser choice to go here, the path of least resistance, because it's what he always does. All it involves doing is saying something about logic, being a Vulcan, skirting the issue, and completely avoiding the whole thing. If there was ever a more obvious choice for Spock, it was just lose the argument and play dumb. But he doesn't do that. We see him make the choice to win the argument. And it's not an easy decision for him either. He even has to prepare himself to respond to McCoy. And he does that. He takes a little bit of a deep breath. He turns to McCoy and he goes, "Really, bitch? Really? I don't know anything about feelings. I know, you know, we all know, really?" To which McCoy can only respond with, "Oh, you know, that's right. Kirk, feelings. You and Kirk, feelings. That's totally fine. I'm worried about it too. I mean, you know, never mind. No harm, no foul. We good." And then the last shot of the entire scene is Spock looking like he had just slaughtered a herd of babies. I mean, he looks really, really guilty. And do I even have to mention the symbolism of Spock being behind prison bars at this particular moment? Because I don't think I do. But the point is that Spock's genuine, warm, decent feelings for Kirk are 100% canon, and you can't knock that down. Also, just one final little note here. This episode was written by Gene Kuhn and Gene Roddenberry. Your argument is invalid.
The Earth vessel?
I'm Captain Kirk.
We come with open hearts and hands.
A Klingon!
Grant, no!
Don't move us!
Yeah. It's a shame they couldn't keep the costume designer off LSD while doing this show. Oh, that's terrible. Oh, yay, 60s. I do want to clarify that obviously your argument is not invalid. I accept all arguments, all points of view. I was just being cocky because the two biggest authorities of Star Trek made Spock's warm feelings for Kirk absolutely canon. And that's all I got. I don't know why you're still here. Tip your driver, validate your parking. Stay tuned after the credits, and also look in this video's info for links to everything but Twitter. Fuck Twitter.